What's happening, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Beastie Boys. Going back to their 1994 album, Ill Communication, once again. And we're up to a tune called Get It Together. As a phrase, you know, it's often used to either normatively, you know, encouraging someone what they should do in terms of, hey, organize things, focus, you know, get ready to act. So usually it's a request or a command to shape up, focus, and make sure you're ready to commit action. You're aware of the conditions and circumstances that you're in. I suppose get it together could also mean, you know, to a group of people or to sort of multiple entities that you're going to have to, you know, find some way to collaborate, to cooperate, to integrate to a certain degree. And, you know, when you're thinking about a group of MCs, the idea of, like, you know, three MCs and a DJ eventually. I know this is not the album with that track, but regardless, you know, there's a degree of integration. You have to get it together. You gotta, you know, nail down your style. And I would say it seems, you know, even if this has nothing to do with where the title comes from, I'm thinking of the way they go through verses where they'll like either alternate like individual lines, or they'll do two lines and another guy will jump in for two lines. Like I've mentioned before, I'm really impressed by the way they sort of split up the lines of their songs, because, you know, in a lot of other cases with large groups of rappers or MCs, it's like this guy's verse and it's, you know, 12 lines, 16 lines or whatever, and then this guy's verse and so on. I've never heard a hip-hop group where they just seamlessly and sort of effortlessly as it seems, which I imagine, you know, there was a lot of work that went into kind of like nailing down that style, but their alternation and sort of like MC roundabouts is really impressive to me. So when I think of Get Together in the context of the Beastie Boys, that's kind of what comes to mind, that like the way they just have this flow and this ability to, you know, go back and forth and integrate over the course of a track. So like I said, it maybe has nothing to do with it, but let's get it. This is Beastie Boys, Get It Together, the seventh track on their 1994 album, Ill Communication. Got some beatboxing? The body rock.
And my mouth is not blood, but fuck it. Let me get down to the rhythm. Yes, I get funky and I shoot
out
the
rhythm like crazy.
The X-rated nigga, listen to the shit, cause I am the ill figure. Nobody's getting any bigger than this.
You have a jazzy feel, I like it.
Phone is ringing, oh my god.
I like those dead pause moments too.
Listen to the shit, cause both of them is bony. Gotta do it like this, like Chachi and Joni.
Gotta get on bottom brains, cause I know that I'm funky.
I'm a funky stubborn, I'm a
disease. Someone mentioned Q-tip shows up.
Cause I back and forth with the quills. Cause I have to tell ya, nigga, cause I keep it under frills. That's the 191-16 air off of Farmer Boulevard.
Yeah, but I'm from Manhattan.
As hard as steel.
Gonna get it together. Watch it.
On the Mohs hardness scale.
Like my belt. I got the ill communication. My belt. Got the ill communication. My belt. Got the ill communication. My belt. Got the ill communication. My belt.
Like the sort of dark jazz feel, that like gritty, grinding sort of bass drone. And again, like, so that was Q-Tip. Is that, am I like hearing that right? Yeah, that was a really cool tune. I enjoyed that one a lot. Definitely didn't hear it before, which is weird. You know, I thought like as we go through this album that, you know, because I know Sabotage, and I remember it being sort of a big hit, I'm sort of on alert that like maybe there's going to be one or two others, because, you know, in this era I did hear some of their music. But yeah, that one I don't remember hearing before, but very cool tune. Again, it seemed like there were a couple references in there. I think there was a Biz Markie reference. Again, maybe like I didn't quite hear that right, but yeah, as I go through these songs, like there are some references that definitely get by me the first time. But then like with successive listens, I try to catch more and more, but do let me know, if I was right about that. Yeah, very much looking forward to going through more of the album. I wonder, because this one so far has had a bit more of a feel of like Paul's Boutique. It feels a bit more like, you know, beats and like DJ turntablism. But we did have Tough Guy, and I think there was another one, I'm blanking on which one it was, that found it or sounded like it was a bit more, was it Bobo on the Corner? I think it was maybe Bobo on the Corner. But yeah, I'm just wondering like which other tracks as we go through might have some more instrumentation, you know, with them playing guitars and drums and so on. Regardless, the next time we come back to the album, we'll be up to, is it, what is that? It's like so hard to read these. Sabrosa? Is it Sabrosa? I can't really read this. It's like the print is not only like small, but it's sort of like stylistic. So, I'll look it up and I'll put it in the comment. I think it says Sabrosa, but again, it's like really hard to read. Regardless, let me know what you think of this tune. I will see you next time. Peace.